we are a social enterprise working on bamboo based livelihoods. So we started in 2008. So this is, I'll let the presentation do most of the talking. So we use bamboo as a raw material to generate livelihoods and use it as a substitute to what we are using today, that is wood, steel, iron and plastic. So that's our main agenda. So we started in 2008. I'll just run. Okay, so there's a misconception mostly in the government setup, basically in the forest department and MOEF, whether bamboo is a grass or a tree. Bamboo is basically a grass. Okay, why we started it, this is the main reason. Triple bottom line effect, which bamboo can really impact the livelihood, environment and financial. Okay, this was the main reason why we started. So I'll take you the main issue. Okay, this is about the market potential. Bamboo based industry in India, though these are only figures, we couldn't even tap 1% out of because of the constraints of the Forest Act we have in India. Housing is the main thing we work, by which we provide livelihoods at the base level. So tribals whom are, you know, who work with us. So we are only stuck in this today, that is basketry. We are only stuck in baskets as far as bamboo industry in India is concerned. We are not even Boeing wings are being tried with bamboo, whereas we are stuck in basketry. Okay, this is what is our main issue we work with. We work in a heavy constraints where government does not give us the raw material. As per the Forest Act, only 6 months a year raw material is provided. From June onwards, harvesting of bamboo is not allowed. So bamboo falls under the concurrent list of the constitution. So you have a state as well as center both having their respective laws on this material. So impacting livelihoods become all the more difficult when you have laws. These are the three laws which basically govern bamboo. So means you have to generate livelihoods and your business model within the constraints. So apart from this is our main difficulties we work with. There is a Forest Act, harvestation anyways not possible. And we work in areas, basically northeast areas, where you know northeast is most of the time is it's landlocked. And most of the time you don't have access to telephones, you don't have, all our tribal communities even don't know how to communicate in Hindi also. So we have to work in those kind of constraints. So media is like social media, smartphones is altogether ruled out. These are some of the constraints. So lack of communication at the base level, scaling anyways ruled out, logistics, supply chain, distribution. Tribal areas, as you know, if you go to Chhattisgarh and Bastar areas, they're again tribal hit. So we have to pull out our business model under those circumstances and create an impact. Okay, while we were through our journey in our initial stage, so these partners were also working at that time in bamboo based activities, so they all partnered with us. So we were able to create some kind of an impact and business model.
Can you please elaborate on the social media?
Yeah, social media, I'll tell you. See, as you can understand, we use social media only to generate and flow, keep a flow on our business. Because as you know, at the base level, my artisans who are landlocked or don't, who are not literate, they will not be able to use anything. So from the last 8 to 10 years, we are able to sustain at least 1000 plus livelihood with the families only because of the social media. So we have a very large presence on social media. So we are more than happy to say at least 1000 families today from Tripura to Assam or, you know, Kerala, all these people are sustaining because of our impact on social media. So that's our major thing. So I'll just run some of the things what we do with bamboo and how social media has really helped us a lot. So more than, you know, 1000 newspapers or magazines and Facebook, we are very active, extremely active. We have a flow of inquiries every day from Facebook. So these are some of the things of our works. So YouTube, we are extremely active. LinkedIn and Twitter, we are very active. So most of our flow of business is because of the social media. So otherwise we would have ceased to exist in this kind of a setup. I'll not take much time. Thank you. Any question? Yeah, please.
Which are the states primarily you are active in the Northeast? Is it Tripura?
Tripura, we are extremely active because that's the most difficult because of Bay of Bengal in between.
Yes.
So you have to go via Bangladesh. Okay. Yes, you cannot come to via, you know, India. So that is one place we are very active. So we have tried to work with a community called Katlamara. It's a small place in Tripura.
Mm-hmm.
So with the help of NID, we have been able to provide a major livelihood to them. But there's a disconnect always. So Assam is one area we are actively working continuously. So our mat making and all these things are there. Kerala is one area we work. We are covering almost all the country.
You said that there was an issue with the government getting the idea wrong about bamboo being a grass or a tree, if I'm not.
No, it is not the idea. MOEF is very clear, it is a grass. But as you know, Forest Department does not want to leave the raw material out of their clutches because there's a lot of revenue involved in bamboo. The moment they leave, they lose the revenue also. So no, Forest Department major source of revenues, you have sandalwood, you have teak and bamboo. If you leave bamboo, they lose a lot of revenue.
You should take this on social media.
No, we have an active page. We have an active page of petitioning the government. Even when Jairam Ramesh was there as ministry, so we have done, you know, done all the work of Gram Sabhas and everything. But finally, it came back to the same spot. So tribals are really suffering, one because of the act, and as you know, there is no chance they are using social media at the back end. So they can. They're totally disconnected. Anybody else?
Because this is all about social media and digital, have you taken digital to the lives of those tribal? I mean,
yes,
I know,
like most of the communities today who were totally illiterate, now they have smartphones, they're using WhatsApp, so Facebook, at least they are communicating with us, you know, what all issues we have within ourselves. At least one person, they are active today, but as you know, by giving them a hand phone, nothing works because they don't have towers also. They work on 2G systems. You know, connecting from Tripura to, we are based in Hyderabad, that itself, yeah, they have to come out 30 kilometers to make a call.
So Tripura is one situation. If you go further, I mean, if you go towards Assam and all, I mean,
Assam back end also, they have same problem. The connectivity is one issue. That's one issue. For example, we work in Sikkim and all these areas. So, and the places where these people stay, again, is a problem.
So only to disseminate the information, you're using the digital platform?
Yes, to create livelihood at the front end. Back end, as you know, we have huge number of issues. Connectivity is an issue, they're using cell phones and smartphones is an issue. We need to be educated. We conduct classes every now and then. But they, you know, they come back to their old lifestyle. For them, they are happy with what they have.
But how about using social media in urban centers? Promoting some of
urban, as you know, India's 66% of bamboo reserves is only in northeast and forest areas.
No, but for use of products.
Products we do, we heavily use. We have huge number of clients who are today with us because of the social media. So we have back end issues which we are not able to sort out. Front end issues on all parts we have sorted out, the marketing, our communication tools and everything. So back end we are literally suffering.
You don't need to answer this one if you don't, but does the black market in the Northeast regarding such products affect your business directly?
Black marketing in a sense?
There's a big market for bamboo being smuggled out of the country because it falls under certain laws.
No, it is not smuggled out of the country. Exporting is not allowed. Exporting, you cannot export bamboo very easily from the country because there are no laws also for India.
At
the customs, anyway, it will get stopped. So customs will not allow. Because from Assam to Hyderabad, it's not allowed.
And
so taking out of the country is ruled out.
What about the ASEAN Highway corridor where it goes till Manipur, Sejo, it goes till down there? It's nothing.
But as you know, usage of bamboo in Northeast is minimal. It is in the central part of the country.
Understood.
Because they have enough resources, they are not very keen on using this. Anyway, I'm short of time. Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.